can see that there's a couple of words that you can use there. Public, protected, nothing, and private. Well, let me just tab back to this one. We can also have the method without any modifier. We can have it be protected or private. This is something that ties to some later lessons as well, but the main point is that you don't always want to allow all of your methods to everybody. So let's for that create some other class. You can do this by right-clicking, saying new Java class, or you can say alt insert, again with the shortcuts. Let's call it helper. And inside of helper, let's just create some public static void method called method, literally. And that one's gonna print out hello from method from class helper. Now we can call this one basically in our main method. I'm gonna just get rid of all this and I'm gonna say helper.method. So this is how you call, this is similar to system out print line, as you've seen, you know, system out print line, it's calling system, then out is some variable, and then print line is the method on that variable. Here, we just have the name of the class and the method that we're calling. So if we run this now, it works. Hello from help class helper. Yeah, I shouldn't have called it method, but whatever. It's just for, you know, demonstrating purposes. Now, what if we want in our helper class to have some methods that are just going to be there for us, that we need some methods, I don't know, to help us calculate something or get something from the database that the user doesn't really need to know about. We can make them private. I can now say private, private method. Of course, I cannot just name it private because that's a keyword and it's complaining. So hello from private method from class helper. Okay, now if I try to say helper dot, I mean, it's not even offering it here, but if I type it on my own private method, it just complains, it's saying something. The method has only private access in the inside of helper. What does that mean? Well, as we've seen on the slide, there's a couple of modifiers. Private is the most restrictive, right? It only allows you to use that method inside of that class, right? And it's similar for variables. Variables can also be, let me just create a couple of variables here, public, static. For now, let's ignore why they all have to be static. We'll cover that at some point, one thing by one. Public, static, integer, I don't know, value equals 5, and do the same thing, value 2 is gonna be like private. And I can also here say something like helper.value equals 5. I can do that, 51. But if I do the same thing with value 2, it's again, I don't even see it. It says value 2 has private access inside of helper. So what is this used for? Well, it's used for example, you're writing some class of your own and you only want to open to the public some of the things from your class. You don't want everything to be publicly visible. So that's why you would want to use this. There's no need, for example, for someone to use your private method. You're doing some stuff there, some maintenance or something. And if I wanted to call my private method here, I can do that because we're still within the class. So now, I mean, I can only call method that's publicly available. And it inside of itself calls the private method. So yeah, I kind of got a hold of the private method, but I mean, that's only because our method, you know, has it inside. If I get rid of this, I can never access this outside of this class. So that's your private keyword. Private means nobody other than the class that it's within can call it. Similarly, I can, we have literally sum here and it's public. So I can go ahead here and say main.sum. And you can see it's already offering me main. Those are all of our public methods, but which one's not public? The non-public one is stop sometime. So let's try to call that one. And now it's complaining because that one is private inside of main, right? So now you understand public and private. Let's move on to the next one. Next one is protected and no modifier. Basically, no modifier means of course, every next level is more restrictive or less restrictive if you go from bottom to top, you know. Private is the most restrictive. That one doesn't allow anybody other than the class that it belongs to call it. No modifier means everybody from that package can call it. What's a package? Well, that's our folder here. Let's create another package. Again, right-click, new package, or if you want to be really cool about it, you can do alt insert, then start typing PA package, and then you can name it something like other package, other underscore package. And now let's inside of that other package create a class called other package class. And inside of here, we can put something like, I don't know, static void other package method. I'm really creative with the names. S out other, it doesn't really matter. The thing is, we're not gonna have any modifier here. I just wanna show you this. Now, if we try to say other package class, it doesn't offer us anything. If I put it to be public, then it'll give us other package method. But one thing to note here, now if I go back here and get rid of the word, it's now having a problem. Now it says this is not visible. Basically cannot be accessed from outside the package. So having no modifier, as you can see in the slide, no modifier is the next level here. So that means that this one can be accessed from within the package, but not from outside. Since our other package class is inside of this other package, as you can see here in the structure, it's inside of here. Nobody from the com.company package can use it. If I move it here, I can just drag, drop it here and hit refactor. Now it's inside of our package, right? Now, as you can see here, it no longer complains. Now this one can use it because it's in within the same package, right? If it's outside of the package, it cannot use it. And if it's inside the package, it can be used because it has no modifier. No modifier only allows the same package classes to use that method or variable. Okay. And the last one is protected. Well, basically, this ties to another lesson about extending classes. So I'm not going to cover that here because there is a way to extend classes from each other, you know, something like this. And then protected would allow you to modify your children's classes. I'm not going to cover that here because it's out of scope for another, I think, couple of lessons. But when we're, of course, I'll remember to mention that because it might be important at that time. For now, you just need to know that there are these access modifiers. You're probably going to most of the time be using public and private. No modifier rarely, let's say, and protected only sometimes, and in exactly that context, when we have a child class, as you can see here. When we have a child class, well, then we can access the children class variables and methods using protected, but nobody else can do it, you know. So yeah, so I'm gonna leave it at that for now. I just want you to understand there's these couple of modifiers, so public, static, public, private, and nothing, and protected. So if we go back to our main thing here, yeah, you can see that we can call other methods from other classes because they're either public, as this one is, we cannot use this one, and we can use the one from here, that one is just without a modifier, meaning it can be accessed from within a package, right? Okay, any questions about these modifiers?